you ever wondered what would happen if you shifted your focus from everything that's troubling you in your life to everything that you love about your life? I've been experimenting with this for a while now, and every time I remain focused on what I love, I get more clarity of thought, and I'm able to solve problems better. New ideas have started coming my way. And more often, on the outside also, there are opportunities that come my way, which is quite unusual and quite amazing, in fact. The fact that I'm here today is one of them. Never thought I'd be doing something like this, talking to a whole lot of people in a room. You put me on stage, and if I have to sing in front of a stadium full of people, I have no issues. This, on the other hand, is not where I'm totally comfortable. Whatever I've done in the film industry was also not planned, whether it was singing for movies or acting in a couple of them. In fact, my whole life has been one big experiment. When I look back now, I can see that everything that happened to me was a reflection of how I felt within. When I was a kid, I was a dreamer. I used to love watching the clouds. I used to love watching ants walking. And I used to ride my cycle and go around discovering new routes and things like that. This was a time when India didn't have TV. So that must be like something that y'all can't even imagine. So forget about smartphones and all. There was no TV in India. So I was outdoors. I was climbing trees and things like that. Now, coming from a family of doctors and teachers, etc., I was the odd one out. So now, what happened is I was called many names, like stupid, good for nothing, and many other beautiful things. There was just enough mental and physical abuse by teachers, students, and a few more such bullies to make me feel like living in a submarine headed for an isolated island. Needless to say, my self-esteem was not so great. I felt like this small guy living in a world of giants. Not living with my parents wasn't easy either. As a kid, I was constantly missing my, constantly feeling sad because I was missing my mom and younger brother. I never felt sad for myself because I thought I was being punished and I deserved it. So in a way, that worked out for me. I never got into that self-pity mode. It was my dad's idea to put me through 9 schools. And the question that I get asked, the question I get asked is whether my dad was in the army. No, he was at home in one town and I was being thrown around at different places, different schools. And the schools were not just from my hometown, it was all over the place. I studied in Bangalore and some of the schools were great schools and some of them were not so great. And I've even lived with people I hardly knew and they hardly knew what I was going through. By the time I was 11 years old, I landed up in Bombay and to live with my grandmom. Now, this was not the ideal place to grow up, to say the least. I don't want to get into details about that. For the longest time, I used to wake up feeling sad. Even though I was not homeless, I had an intense longing for a sense of home, which kept me constantly in a state of stress. The sadness I felt literally hurt physically. I had no idea how to get out of this feeling. Then one day there was something that happened within the family concerning me. It was like an intervention kind of thing. I don't want to talk about what the details about the incident, but it changed all that sadness into anger in an instant. I was like, I just started feeling like, you know, nobody is willing to understand what I'm going through, so to hell with everyone. And at that moment, that anger that I felt, it felt good. And it felt better than feeling sad, because sad was like a helpless feeling. And this anger gave me some sense of power. But the thing is, it didn't take much time for that anger to turn into hate. I started judging people like I never did before, putting down whoever I felt was weaker than me, and feeling inferior to most people and superior to some. This went on for a few years. The anger never left me and was like a sleeping monster ready to strike. I had no idea how to function in society. I had no real social skills. And so was very awkward in situations where I had to communicate with others, like right now. Everything that I learned in life, I had to learn the hard way, falling down, making mistakes, and so on. Sometimes life throws you a lifeline. And for me, that was music. Towards the end of my college days, I met this guitarist who became a good friend. And one day, and he had a rock band. And one day we were with his band, we were sitting outside a church and looking at all these pretty girls pass by. And I liked one of the girls, so I started singing to her. And nobody in that band had ever heard me sing. In fact, nobody, like hardly two people knew that I could sing. So the singer of the band asked me whether I would like to sing backups in the band. And I was in such a good mood at that time, I said, yeah, okay, I'll come. And the next day I landed up in their practice room. And when I heard that guitar sound and that rock band playing, and when my chance came to sing on that mic, the feeling that I got at that moment was something that I'd never felt in my entire life. It was pure joy. And I wanted to hold on to that feeling. So I decided right there and then that this is what I'm going to do from now on. By the time the show came near, I ended up being the lead singer of the band because the band guys said, like, I mean, they liked me, my singing, and they just kept encouraging me to get more and more songs. So I became the lead singer of the band. And the very first time I was on stage, never been on stage in school, in college, and the first time I'm on stage was at a rock show in front of a big crowd. And it was amazing. And the way the show went off, it was great. And the people who knew me were shocked because they thought I was possessed or something because they just couldn't believe that I could be like that on stage. So for me, music, and specifically rock music, gave me the freedom to be whoever I wanted to be in those moments when I was on stage. Till date, when I hear that rock sound, that guitar sound, I still become that same joyful kid. You should see me at practices and all. I'm still, you know, that same feeling gets me. And that's the reason why I still do it. So as long as I was on stage, I was fine. But off stage, again, no experience in dealing with day-to-day life. I still had that hate, anger, sadness combo, which made my view of the world very murky. There was also this deep sense of guilt by this time because I started playing in bands and I started playing a few shows and things like that. So this guilt started coming up about going against everyone in the family and doing something which was so uncertain that you never knew where your money is going to come from or what your potential future is going to be. Even I didn't know. So the people at home were like, you know, what the hell are you up to? Because I was singing in English, in a rock band in India, when there was no music channels, no internet, nothing. Nowadays on YouTube, you can just go and put out your songs and things like that. I'm a dinosaur, basically. But for me, being in a band was the only place I found some happiness. So I stuck to it. I didn't realize it at that time. But that one decision I made led to where I am today. A decision I made just because I loved singing in a rock band. There was absolutely no other thought to that decision. I've been through a lot of ups and downs since then. It took me years to figure out how those great moments happened and how those low moments happened. All I wanted to do was sing in a rock band. Everything else happened in my life as a result of that, doing that. I never went out of my way to search for work. Every opportunity that came to me was because of that one decision. Fellow musicians from other bands got into studio work. And one of my friends was Rupert Fernandez, who called me to sing You and I in This Beautiful World, which was the Hutt jingle, which became one of the longest playing ads in India. Then Vishal Dadlani, when he and Shekhar were doing their first film, he called me to sing in that movie, and I sang one song. The song wasn't a hit or anything, but that was my first film song. After that, I sang many songs in films. Some of them were hits, some of them were not. But for me, it didn't really matter what happened to the song after it was released. For me, it was the process of recording and singing, which I totally enjoyed. In fact, I used to forget what I sang by the time I got home. My wife used to ask me, like, what did you do today? Like, which film? I forgot. So when Give Me Some Sunshine was released, I was shocked to see the impact it had on the audience. I was not even thinking about anything, so it was a big shock. Anyway, by this time, I'd already gotten over a lot of my insecurities. What I've come to realize is that the more judgmental you are, the less you know yourself. Because you're using a lot of your energy to focus on what's wrong with yourself and others. You may feel that you're doing it to protect yourself, but actually, you're just focusing on the negative. And that can make your life an unnecessary struggle. Every decision based on fear can lead to more and more situations that will eventually make your life unnecessarily stressful. Anger, resentment, guilt, etc., when suppressed, can easily lead to hate. And then hate is like the poison that's slowly killing you, even though it may be directed at others. One of the main reasons for hate to exist, according to me, is a lack of love. People spend their entire lifetime looking for that love to come from outside. This love, I feel, cannot come from outside. It has to come from within. The only way to get out of this loop is to love yourself. This is where I shifted my focus even further from what I love to learning to love myself. You don't have to become something to love yourself. You have to learn to love yourself as you are, with all your so-called faults and imperfections. When you learn to do that, it'll become much more easier to achieve whatever you want to achieve, because you will be doing exactly what you love doing. You won't have to do anything just to get some approval from others, because you won't need it. Then it's up to you how successful you want to be. You can be number one or number 83, but it doesn't matter, because you'll be exactly where you want to be, not where you're supposed to be according to others. When I first realized this, it wasn't easy for me to suddenly love myself. It still is a work in progress. So the first step I took was self-acceptance. I decided to be okay with who I was at the moment. I stopped hiding from my so-called negative side. But I wasn't complacent. I didn't just say, this is who I am and it's all okay. You know, I wanted to feel better on the inside so that I could do better on the outside. Love is a subtle but very powerful creative force. Hate, on the other hand, is very loud and sometimes even glamorous but destructive force. It only leads to self-destruction. Every time you focus on hate, you're inviting misery into your life. It'll come in some form or the other. It might come into your relationships, finances, health, or all three. It does take courage to love. So the point I'm trying to make is that you can either drag yourself through life or you can ride the waves of life like a surfer. I've noticed a lot of people who've had lifelong resentment, guilt, shame, hate, etc., and have had major health issues as they've gotten older. They also tend to age faster. Many of these people were very successful people. The way I look at it is, no matter what you've achieved in life, if you're still miserable and unhappy, you failed. So when you're driven by love, your achievements will not only fulfill you, but many others without you going out of your way to help others. It'll just become a natural flow of events. You'll have the clarity to achieve all your goals without having to step over or put down others. There are countless examples of people who are like that, millionaires and billionaires. So it's not something which I'm just like imagining that might happen. But on the other hand, the need to feel superior to others has brought down mighty kings and emperors. Many of them have had very shameful endings. For me, it's not what you achieve, it's how you achieve is what is important. The greatest of artists in any field have been doing this for ages. They were not driven by the need for acceptance or love from the world. They were driven by the love for what they had to offer. So when you love yourself unconditionally, you no longer live like a beggar waiting for the world to accept and love you. You are in a powerful position to achieve whatever you want to achieve without being needy. When you build on a foundation of love, there's no limits to the heights to what you can achieve. On the other hand, if your foundation is hate, you're starting off on shaky ground and it's bound to crumble sooner or later. It's one thing having this knowledge and a whole different thing applying it in your life. So I'm saying all these things as I'm trying to apply it also. All the emotions that are connected to hate are robbing you of your opportunity to shine. I know this from personal experience. Emotions are like ingredients. You can use them to destroy yourself and others, or you can use them to bring out the greatness that exists in everybody. So have fun, do what you love, enjoy life, make yourself feel so good that you can't help but share that feeling with everybody. I know what I've said today is nothing new. There are a lot of people who have gone through way more tougher situations than what I've just described. And yet, there's so much of hate in the world today. It's like history repeating itself. And people keep saying that, you know, we want to change the world. How can you change the world when you can't even love yourself? That was my point in this whole story that I told you. Thank you. But now, I want all of your help to sing a song with me.
मर के जी लिए एक पल तो अब हमें जीने दो सारी उम्र हम मर मर के जी लिए एक पल तो अब हमें जीने दो ना 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 Na 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 na. Give me some sunshine. Give me some rain. Give me another chance. I wanna grow up once again.